Today, let us see unit 3, polymer concrete, sulfur infiltrated concrete and fiber reinforced concrete. First, let me explain about polymer concrete. Polymer concrete is a special concrete. Polymer concrete is an aggregate bound with a polymer binder instead of Portland cement as in conventional concrete. The main technique in producing polymer concrete is to minimize voids volume in the aggregate mass so as to reduce the quantity of polymer needed for binding the aggregates. Properly grading and mixing the aggregates to attain the maximum density and minimum void volume. The graded aggregates are prepacked and vibrated in a mold. Here, monomer is then diffused up through the aggregates and polymerization is initiated by radiation or chemical means. And also, it is a saline coupling agent is added to the monomer to improve the bond strength between the polymer and the aggregate. In case polyester resins are used, no polymerization is required. Properties of polymer concrete. Polymer concretes tend to be brittle, and it is reported that dispersion of fiber reinforcement would improve the toughness and tensile strength of the material. The strength obtained with polymer concrete can be as high as 140 MPa with a short curing period. For a less curing period, we can attain up to 140 MPa in polymer concrete. That is the main advantage. Polymers can be made compact with minimum voids and are hydrophobic and resistant to chemical attack. The use of fibrous polyester concrete in the compressive region of RC beam provides a high strength ductile concrete at reasonable cost. We can produce ductile concrete in polymerization, polymer concrete. Okay. Next one, sulfur infiltrated concrete, that is SIC. Sulfur infiltrated concrete is made in a similar way to polymer impregnated concrete. It is similar to polymer impregnated concrete. But since sulfur is considerably cheaper than monomers and the impregnation technique is simpler, there will be obvious cost benefit. Sulfur infiltrated concrete is obtained by infiltrating the lean concrete with the molten sulfur. The water cement ratio of the concrete to be infiltrated should be high, between 0.7 to 0.8. Here, sulfur infiltrated concrete, the water cement ratio is high, that is more than 0.4. It ranges from 0.7 to 0.8. So that there is no need for external pressure to drive in the sulfur because of more water cement ratio. The infiltration procedure consists of moist curing of concrete for 24 hours at 23 degree centigrade, followed by drying at about 121 degree centigrade for a period of 24 hours. It is a period for about only 24 hours. The concrete is immersed in molten sulfur for a period of time, which depends on the type and size of the member. So we can decide based on the type and size of the member. For concrete with a water cement ratio of order 0.65, the 1 day old elements must be handled with care to avoid damage. The drying temperature should be kept as high as possible, but not exceeding 150 degree, because the higher temperature may damage the gel structure of the young hydrated cement paste. Next one, fiber reinforced concrete, FRC. Let us see what is fiber reinforced concrete. FRC is defined as concrete made with hydraulic cement containing lime or fine and coarse aggregate and discontinuous discrete fibers. The fibers can be made from natural material like asbestos, sisal fibers, cellulose, or as a manufactured product such as glass, carbon, and polymers like polypropylene, etc. A description: about the fibers. A fiber reinforced concrete requires a considerably greater amount of fine aggregate than that for conventional concrete for convenient handling. Here in fiber reinforced concrete we need more fine aggregate comparing with the conventional concrete, because we use discrete fibers, so we have to add more fine aggregate, right? In FRC, for FRC to be fully effective, each fibers needs to be fully embedded in the matrix. Thus, the cement paste requirement is more. So, we need here more cement paste for completely embedment of fibers in the concrete. We need more cement matrix. For FRC, the cement paste required ranges between 35% to 45% as against 25% to 35% the conventional concrete. Conventional concrete we need 25% to 35% paste, but whereas in FRC we need more than that, 35% to 45%, because we need more cement paste for complete immersion of fibers in the cement paste. Asbestos cement fibers so far have proved to be commercially successful, right? Behavior of fiber reinforced concrete. The tensile cracking strain of cement matrix is about 1/50th of that of yield of steel fibers. Consequently, when FRC is loaded, the matrix cracks long before the fibers are fractured. The cracks occurs before fracture occurs. Once the matrix is cracked, the composites continue to carry increasing tensile stress, provided the pullout resistance of fibers at the first crack is greater than the load at the first cracking. The bond or pullout resistance of the fibers depends on the average bond strength between the fibers and the matrix. After the first crack, fibers continue to take load provided the bond is good. Thereafter, the fibers reaching the breaking strain fracture. The neutral axis of the section shifts and the fibers of adjacent layers fracture on reaching the breaking strain. Failure occurs when the concrete in compression reaches the ultimate strain. Types of fiber reinforced concrete. Steel fiber reinforced concrete, polypropylene fiber reinforced concrete, glass fiber reinforced concrete, high fiber volume concrete, slurry infiltrated fiber concrete, compact reinforced composites. Thank you.